1, 1, 2. Check me out right here, yo.
Mike the True Jackson here, 4 Ounce Fight Club, for another edition of Fighters Talk. Today I'm joined by the Wolverine, Justin Reiswerg. Justin, how you feeling today?
I'm feeling good. Just getting here to the gym now.
Yeah, next week, you're co-main eventing, Legacy 37. Now you're taking on the Greek, Mike Bronzoulis, at 155 pounds. Now, this will be the Greek's first time at 155. What are your thoughts on that weight cut?
I've known him for a long time. I've always thought he was kind of a bigger guy, definitely, than me. So I think getting 155 is going to be tough for him because I'm usually one of the bigger ones at this weight class. I don't know if he's made a practice cut. I kind of hope he has so that he knows what he's getting into, because I remember my first time going from 170 to 155, not an easy thing.
No, not at all. But shit, I remember my first time making 155, and I was like, yeah, I don't know about this. People say they saw him not too long ago. They said he's slimming down and he's looking a little bit leaner. So maybe he did. Well, the Greek, he's going to take things seriously. So maybe that was his way of sort of practice getting his weight down.
Yeah, I think so. I think, he's going to be a little bit smarter about it. He's going to try and get his body weight as close down as he can. I just, one of his things has always been his cardio and his strength, and I don't know if that's going to carry over to 55. That's the only thing that, it doesn't concern me, but, that's one of the issues that we are looking into this fight.
Good deal. Now, the Greek, we know he's very tough, very durable. Now, he's coming in on a three-fight skid at 170. Do you feel the drop to 155 is his way of revitalizing his career?
I think it's a way for him to kind of shake things up. Maybe he's gotten a little bored at 170, or maybe he just feels like he himself is too heavy and he feels like he should be lighter. I don't know, though, but we're going to find out. He picked a tough test for starting at 155.
I definitely agree. For you, on the other hand, you're riding a three-fight winning streak going into the fight, co-main eventing. Now, with the win over someone like Mike Bronzoulis, who's a Strike Force veteran, Bellator veteran, he was on the Fight Master Series, what do you think a win over the Mike Bronzoulis will do for your career?
I think it does a lot for me. Even my manager over a first round said, he's like, Bronzoulis is a good name. He's got a good record. You've got a pretty good record. Getting this win will mean a lot for your career, not just another guy, Last couple of opponents have been, mediocre guys. This is definitely a step up in competition. Pass this test, should be looking good.
Definitely. Now, going into the fight, like I said, he's a very tough guy. He has a solid wrestling ground. What kind of strategy do you have for someone who could possibly be bigger and stronger than you come fight night?
Bigger and stronger is not really an issue. If we're near the same size the day before, you can't be that much bigger, and in my opinion, you can't be that much stronger, really. But we plan on nullifying that with speed, footwork, and technique. Technique kills all.
That's very true. Again, co-main eventing this. You have several of your teammates fighting on the card as well. How's training been going with so many guys that are competing at the same time?
Training's good. We get a lot of good training. I don't bump up to where Larry Crow's at. That's a little big for me, but we'll mix it up with Jeff Neal, who's fighting at 170, and then Daniel Pineda, who is now fighting at 155 too, apparently. So, we've got plenty of size right around the same, and just mix it up.
There you go. Well, definitely looking forward to seeing the Wolverine back in the cage.
Appreciate it, Truth.
Good luck on your fight.